Hello friends, again we are here with the new point, that Lamy's theorem. So already we have seen the number of problem related to the equilibrium, and that Lamy's theorem point is also from the equilibrium chapter. Now when the word equilibrium comes, that time the few things comes in the mind. At the time of doing the design of any component, we need to find out the reaction force, support forces, or the unknown forces. So, but when the body is in the equilibrium, then for that, basically the few methods are there, and on the basis of that few methods, we can find out the unknown or the support reactions or the angle which is present there. So already we have discussed about the analytical and graphical method, which was related to the beam reactions. So beam related problem was related to the analytical and graphical method. Now when the three forces are present there, and these three forces are in a concurrent position, and if they are passing through the single point, then, and if these all forces are in the same plane, then the situations will change, and we couldn't use the analytical and graphical method. For that time, at that time, we need to use the another method, and that method name is Lamy's theorem. That method name is Lamy's theorem. Now, first of all, this is the Lamy's theorem. Now, before going to the numerical, we have to be clear with the Lamy's theorem, and then we will be able to solve the number of numerical. So this is the second part of our equilibrium chapter. Now comes to the second window. Here the some bright and visible PPT. So you can see the statement has mentioned what is meant by the Lamy's theorem. It states that if the three forces acting at a point on a body keep it body at rest, then each force is proportional to, then every force will be proportional to the sine of the angle between the two other forces. What that means? If the three forces acting at a point, consider this is as, consider the one body is present here. If on that body the three forces are acting, so three forces means this is the one force, this is the second, this is the third force. If these three forces are acting at a point on a body, and if that body is not moving from that place, that body is in the same position or in an equilibrium position, then each force, then every force means force P, force Q, force R, then each force is proportional to the sine of the angle between the other two forces, means the angle will be of the opposite two forces. So if I consider, here is the example I mentioned, if we think about the P force, then P will be proportional to the sine of alpha. P will be, so here is the P will be, P will be proportional to the opposite angle, the sine of angle. So P proportional to the sine of alpha. Same way the Q is proportional to the sine of beta. If I rearrange this, then I will get mathematically the equation P upon sine alpha, P upon opposite angle sine alpha, then Q upon sine beta, Q upon again opposite angle sine beta, and R upon opposite angle sine gamma. And this is the Lamy's theorem. Now the some limitations also are in Lamy's theorem. It is useful when the body is in equilibrium, when the body is not moving, when the number of three forces acting on it, only the three forces. Second point is not useful for the non-concurrent force system. If the forces are not passing through the same point, applicable only for the three forces, applicable only for the three forces. It is not useful for the non-concurrent force system. And last point is not applicable for the non-coplanar force system. If the forces not lying in a single plane, then it will, in that case, the Lamy's theorem will not be applicable. So consider this slide as a one plane. So in that plane, whatever the forces are, these are the coplanar. If the plane is going into the another plane, then it will not be the coplanar force. So these are the limitations for the applications of Lami's theorem. Now the uses of Lami's theorem. What is the use of Lami's theorem? To find out the tensions in the string, whatever the strings, consider this rope, and this rope is holding the one holding the bulb. So if you want to find out the tensions into these strings or the tension into these strings, that time also you can use the Lami's theorem. Or in the rope, cable and wire, whatever the tension is happening, that tensions will be found out by Lami's theorem. Then the second is to find the inclination of the string. Inclination of string means the angle. Find the angle between the forces alpha, beta, gamma, and the unknown forces in the G, tie, and the reactions at the point of contact. Reactions, consider this is the inclination plane, this is the second inclination plane. If the body is there, so whatever the point of contact is creating here, so that is nothing but the one kind of reactions. So these are the reaction forces also can be find out by the Lami's theorem. Now come to the second, some example pattern also has mentioned. So here you can see the one inclined plane, there is the second fixed plane, again third fixed plane is again, and in between there is the one sphere or ball. So what that means, the ball is making the contact with this and this inclined plane at the point A and B. So what will happen, the some force by the wall will act on the circular object, on this ball. So the direction will be inward. So that's why here is the separate diagram. So this way the arrow will go, and for the point B again this way the arrow will go. But due to the self weight, the body also will show the another arrow, that will be the downward. So finally we will get this kind of the diagram. So this arrow indicate the A point, and the second arrow indicate the B point, and third is the W weight. Again the second example is, again there is a fixed beam, these are the two strings, and the third string is holding the mass. So again here is the all forces are in one plane, all are the concurrent because these forces are passing through the single point, and all the conditions are matching here, though the Lami's theorem can be applicable. This is the way to identify the numerical, and then we can solve the numerical very easily. So from tomorrow we will see the Lami's theorem related numerical. Thank you.